Hey guys, Cringe here, and I want to talk about some video game ass video games in this episode. Episode? Sure. I run a TV show. This is... sure. I haven't really had a whole lot of time when I've been getting home from work lately, and so what I've been going to is not necessarily newer games where I feel like I kind of want to sink a lot more time into these games and dedicate a lot more energy to them. So what I've been getting home lately, what I've been going to actually is Xbox 360 games. I've hooked up my Xbox 360 Slim with a bunch of games installed, and there are two of them that I've been going back to pretty regularly over the last week or so, and those are Final Fantasy XIII 2 and Tomb Raider. Now, let me just justify that. Tomb Raider is not necessarily too hard. It was a pretty well-received game when it came out. And as far as how it holds up today, a lot of the gameplay, a lot of the sort of storytelling, the cutscenes, the characters, the plot, the visuals even, like they hold up all right. It's easy to see that it's a 360 game, but even then, it's fine. It's fine. The way that I want to justify Final Fantasy XIII 2 is by drawing some of the similarities between 13-2 and Tomb Raider. Namely that you have periods of time of gameplay where it is loosely involved in some sense. You're kind of following an objective. In the case of Final Fantasy XIII-2, you hit X and you have your map there and you're like, cool, let's go in that direction. In the case of Tomb Raider, you hit one of the bumpers and it lights up the part of the world that you need to follow. And then there are stretches of it where it's just more traditional storytelling aspects like cutscenes, and you can just sort of step back and let it do what it needs to. The reason I kind of wanted to bring this up is because game tropes are often a little bit, like, sort of begrudgingly mentioned that they're part of modern games, particularly games that might be trying to disrupt or games that are trying to really do something new and do something fresh in the space. 13-2 and Tomb Raider don't even try to shy away from any of that. And I appreciate that they were both, you know, old-ish at this point. I think it was 2012 and both 2012 games, I'm pretty sure. But the reason why I've been going back to them is because it is really, really easy to jump in, play a little bit, watch a little bit of cutscene, scroll through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Grindr, and then just walk away. And also, I mean, autosave is phenomenal, by the way. Why the fuck don't game? Why did Final Fantasy XV not... I'm still bitter about Final Fantasy XV. But yeah, I'm sure there are a few other 360 games that I'm wanting to jump into. I've got 70 installed on my 360, actually. It's one of the slim ones with it. I think it's a 320 gig hard drive, so I can only imagine how many you could install on one of the 500 gig hard drives. But if you've got any 360 games that you think I should jump into, please let me know in the comments. Odds are I've already got it installed and would love to jump into it. And what some of the game tropes are that are similar to what I've said in Tomb Raider and Final Fantasy XIII. I didn't actually touch on a lot of the specific stuff that I love about 13-2 and Tomb Raider, namely that Tomb Raider feels very good to play. It feels very satisfying to engage with the world as far as gameplay is concerned. And then Final Fantasy XIII-2, it's just so unapologetically silly sometimes. Like, I think that's what I need. Something that doesn't really take itself too seriously. Maybe it did. It's not coming across that way, but yeah, let me know what you think I should be playing in the comment section of this video. If you want to see more of whatever it is that I do in the future, subscribe to the channel, youtube.com/cringeworthy, memes and fan art, twitter.com/cringeworthy, you know the drill. And if you want to see more of me in your life, just sort of generally, Instagram is where I've been posting lately as @cringeworthy, and you can see all of my dumb selfies there. But for now, thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you soon.